There is no doubt in my mind that every time I come to this place, I'm absolutely awestruck of the beauty of it. Where am I? Well, I'm at Ratherheath in the Lake District, and I'm carp fishing. And this has to be one of my favorite lakes of all time. And I've been to a few now. This one takes the biscuit. It really is a beautiful place to come and fish, and I love it. Welcome to Math2 UK. And welcome to Ratherheath. Hello and welcome back to Math2 UK. Yes, I'm talking really, really quiet, and the reason for that is because I'm back at Ratherheath Tarn, which is in the Lake District. It's absolutely a beautiful place. I really, really love this place. But sound travels so far here, and you can hear people talk on the furthest parts of the lake, and you got to be really, really quiet. It is a wonderful place. I'm here just for a 24-hour session. So I'm doing an overnight, as you can see. My rods are already out. I'll explain what I'm doing in a minute. I'll explain my tactics and I'll talk about the bait that I'm using. In the meantime, welcome to Math2 UK. So then, where have I been? Well, this is a brand new camera. It's my new 4K camera. So this video is gonna be in 4K. I look forward to doing the editing process as well, because not only have I got a new camera that does 4K, my old computer wouldn't process that because it's far too much information. So I've been and bought a new computer as well. So I've got this all singing, all dancing editing software, all singing, all dancing computer, and I've got this technically all singing, all dancing camera. My other camera gave up the fight. It had too many knocks. It had been out in too many bad days, and I was starting to lose footage, and I was getting back and some of the footage wasn't there anymore. So it was time for that camera to go. Hence why I've not actually been and produced a video for quite a while, because I didn't have the ability to. So what am I doing? What are my tactics? Well, you're only allowed two rods on here. One of my rods is right in the margin. There's some lily pads just down here. Can you see the lily pads? I've got one, and I've baited up that area, and I've got one rod in there. I've got Hinder's seafood with a pop-up cut in half on the top to balance it. And the other one I've got, just plopped it out in the middle there. It's not a very wide lake. It's probably 50 meters across at most. So 3 to 4 wraps out just in the center. Both of those areas I've seen a little bit of messing around earlier. Again, I've got a seafood pop-up on that one, topped with a couple of sweet corn. Put some sweet corn out on top of that as well, catapulted some of that out. Yeah, it's quite busy. There's only 5 bivvies allowed on overnight here. And when I turned up, there's about 3 or 4 cars and 3 or 4 bivvies up, so they shouldn't be here. There should be quite a quiet night. So I might be able to raise my voice slightly. There's a chap fishing just over opposite me. Again, he's fishing in the margins. It appears to be a lot of margin fishing, everyone that you speak to. Now, I was advised to go into peg and fish the margins and fishing, but when I had a walk around and I seen some fish move over here in around the lily pads down by that next island, I just thought, well, despite the great advice from Paul, thank you, Paul, I've got to fish where the fish are. And if I set my bivvy up over the opposite side of the bank there, chances if somebody moved into that peg, I couldn't fish it. So my catapult broke. I've had to repair my catapult already. there's sweet corn everywhere. just as I was the first pull as well. So I hadn't looked at my catapult for a couple of months, and as soon as I pulled back on it, it snapped. And of course, sweet corn went all over my swim. But I'm sure the ducks will sort that out for me later. In the meantime, I did get here really early. I got here about 4:45 in the morning. So it is actually time for a brew. So I'm going to get myself a brew on, maybe a bit of a Scooby snack as well. I'm going to keep topping up the bait quite a lot because there are lots of silverfish, and I know for a fact they'll mop up that sweet corn quite a lot. I'll show you some of my mix. I've got my baits in a minute, so later on I'll show you what mix I've got from the margins. I can't catapult a lot of that out further because it'll just go everywhere. But I'm really, really pleased to be out. I've got my small bivvy, and I've got my small bed. I'm not a small person, so I'm hoping it doesn't pour down. This is the Lake District. Chances are it will. The weather forecast is good, but that doesn't mean anything up around here. So yeah, pleased to be out. Pleased to be back on the bank again. Let's get a brew on. Yeah, I'm a bit camera shy. Getting plenty of action on my left-hand rod here. Yep. I wasn't 100% happy with that rig, but if it goes, I think I've got a small fish on the end of it. So what I may have to do if it keeps bobbing up and down like it is, I'll see if I can get that in the shot for you. Yeah, there's a small fish on that. Nobody really wants a slime ball, but it's a first fish and it's after an hour's fishing, so it's a start. Yuck. And away it goes, and good riddance to it. So that's the rig. It's a stiff rig with a little white pop-up on it. Nothing really unusual about that. Pretty standard stuff, but I've got a inline lead with this one. No leaders or anything. Just straight off the line with a stiff rig. There you go. Just put a little PVA bag on with that. When I cast out, job's a good one. Well, I hope you're well. I'm still getting some knocks and some disturbance liners on the right-hand rod. Nothing on the left-hand rod, but I keep baiting that up. Start off with a bream, just like last time. If I get any more bream, I'll have to up the size of the bait, and I'll probably put on some larger pop-ups, try and keep the bream away. But I'll still keep the particles and the bits and bobs that I've got going in as well, just to keep the fish in the area, really. What have I got coming up in the future? Well, we've got the fishing blogger social coming up in a month's time. Dave and I going down there, down south. Cookham Farm, Long Lake, somewhere like that it's called. Really looking forward to that. I know Dave and I, we haven't done a lot at all so far this year. So it's just a question of trying to get out when we can. Yeah, I've missed it. We've done a lot of training for Hadrian's Wall Walk. So I know Dave is fit as a racing snake at the moment. He's doing a lot of running and he's doing a lot of training. I'm afraid I'm the only one that isn't really doing a lot. So I'm doing as much as I can, but when I get back from work, you know, it's taking its toll on me. So I've got to up my game a little bit and try and get a little bit more weight off before September. But I am working on it. I am starting to lose weight, which is really good. But it's a slow process at my age. It's not quick, is it? You'll probably know. Yeah, a lot of fish down on the island, just down to my left. I keep seeing them. I'm sort of now wishing that I'd moved down to that bit further down. But even if I was fishing further down here, they're behind the island, so I couldn't be on the fish exactly. Carp King 71's now got his passport, and I know Dave is gonna start booking the next French trip, and of course Chris is gonna come along with us, so that should be good fun. Chris's first European fishing trip. He's probably gonna kick our asses, but I mean, there you go. But he'll have some way to go to beat Dave, that's for sure. Here we go again. Right hand rod's just gone. Whether that was a liner or not, I don't know. Or whether I've just missed a trick. No, steadied up. I have brought with me some floaters, but with the amount of ducks I see here, I'm not sure I'd be able to get any joy with that. There's no seagulls, just ducks. So, not really gonna be able to do it, because as soon as I put some floaters out, them greedy gits are gonna go mop it up. What I need to do is, I need them to bugger off. There is an awful lot of movement down at the island over there. An awful lot. And I genuinely am contemplating moving, because the amount of fish that are showing over the island, I know I'm only here for 24 hours, and I know it's a mess around, but the amount of movement over there, how long would it actually take me to move there? Probably, what, half an hour, 45 minutes to get my gear over to there? I'm gonna go and have a look. Shall we go and have a look? Let's see, let's go and have a look. So this is what I was talking about with this gimbal. I'm walking along the bank. I'm only going the next swim down. I'm not going far. But let's have a look at the next swim. See, I'm in those lily pads there, which to me is a great spot. But what I keep seeing is a lot of fish moving. Just up the end of that island there. Just here. Yeah. Do you know what? I'm gonna do it. Well, within 10 minutes of moving, I put my rod where I was seeing the fish earlier and I had a run. But unfortunately, it snagged me up. So all I can do now is just let the line loose and hopefully it'll play itself out. But yeah, I knew it was a good idea to move, but I need to be quicker underneath these trees next time, because it's straight straight under, snagged me up straight away. And I literally just finished moving. So the rod's only been in 10 minutes. So good shout, but I'm snagged. Let's see, here we go. Well, unfortunately, I lost that one, but I got my rig back, which I'm really pleased about. I left it for about 15 minutes, just loose line, hoping that the fish would, if it was still on, that it would free itself, let itself go. It's worked in the past, but unfortunately this time, no. But I did get everything back. So there's my rig. Back. So I'm a bit disappointed I've lost it, but I'm not disappointed for moving, because within 10 minutes I had a run. That's going straight back where it is. But what I realize now is that I'm gonna have to be straight on my rods. No messing, no ifs, no buts. As soon as that rod go, I'm gonna have to strike on it, because I can't afford to keep snagging up. I certainly can't fish there at night. It's just too, I won't be quick enough. By the time I got out of my pit, I would have been snagged up again. So I'm gonna go put it back in exactly the same spot and see if I can do it again. And there we go. Three o'clock. It's dropped off quite a bit. The wind's sort of dying down a bit, but since I've had that run off that corner, I've not had anything else, no knocks, no nothing. So I've changed over to my secret weapon, because I am limited for time, which is the Hinders XO. I've said it before, probably my favorite bait is probably what I've caught most fish on these. So when I get a little bit desperate, I put these on and hopefully I'll get a run. They're, as always, it's me they catch more than anything. But we're all guilty of that. I've also got a bag of pellet with some goo on it. Not the thick stuff, but the thinner goo. So I've got a little bag of pellet with the goo soaked in that, and hopefully that will have an effect. The only trouble is, because that goo is so thin, it gets everywhere. And I thought I was being clean and tidy by putting it on my little bivy table. My wooden table's not here today. There's one thing about this place, is that You've got to, if you're going to come round the side here, you've got to travel light. One, because you've only got 24 hours anyhow. And two, because the route for your burrow is quite difficult. Not an easy route. Look, looks like you've had a nosebleed. So you've got to be, you've got to try and be as light as possible, because that's a tough route. And with the burrow, my burrow, I don't know, it seems to sort of like dig in on every lump and bump. So, yeah. So I've not got my table with me, I'm just using my bivy table, but I'm fine. I always bring my wooden table, purely and simply because it's just nice. I like using it. It's, I don't know, there's something about using that little wooden table that I really like. And I've always used it, and I always will, as long as I've got it. As long as I don't leave it behind somewhere. Yes. Cheers. No Mafti UK Cup, you'll notice. I've only got one left. I've given them all away now. I just isn't any left. I've got one that I have in its box at home. And after that, I need to get some more. I had to get some more made. I think I will, because there was a few people that wanted them, which I thought was quite nice. And for those of you that ended up with them, I hope you still got them. But I think what I'm going to do is next time, if I do get any more mugs, I'll make the more outdoor-friendly version, sort of like a tin mug or something. I don't know. I'll have to have a look at what's available, what I can do, how I can print on it, or maybe even change the logo altogether. I don't know. And then give them away. If you're sticking with me, thank you very much. I'm 6,300 subscribers now. Well, nearly, just under 6,300. I'm absolutely over the moon with that, because this isn't a dynamic channel. There's nothing dynamic about what I do. It's just me. So if you're one of those people that watch these videos and enjoy them, well, thank you very much. One thing I will say. The last video I did, which was the charity video. Quite a few of you have mentioned that next time we do that at Wareside or wherever we do it, you'd like to come along. Well, I don't have a problem with that, because the more people that turn up, the better it is. So when we do the next charity event with Paul, what I want you to do is I will drop a note on Facebook or something like that, and if you want to come along, you can do, to get the numbers up and to make it a much more bigger event. And I think that's Paul's aim. So if you want to come along to that video, sorry, if you want to come along to that weekend and help Paul raise more money for his charity, then please do so. It is important. So yeah, those people that have contacted me already, I think I've replied to some of you and saying, yeah, no dramas. You want to come, please do so. Keep your eyes open about the same time next year, and then please come along and boost the numbers and make it more important for Paul. Okay, those exos are shite. They've been in 20 minutes, have not caught out. I'm really curious to see how this video turns out, purely and simply because it's the 4K stuff and not your normal HD. So I think you get warts and all, don't you? This evening will be chicken tikka masala with mini naan breads. Nothing new, nothing exciting, but very tasty. Bon appetit. Well, the chap over there just pulled one out. That's the first carp, well, second carp I've seen today, actually. I'll leave him to his fish, but well done. Maybe they're starting to bite now. Let's hope so. Yeah, so as you've just seen, just to be on the safe side, I've moved out into the middle of the lake as opposed to the margins. And the only reason is purely and simply, it's just too snaggy in the left. And I don't want to put anything under here. I don't want to go into any snags in the middle of the night. So it's only dark for 4 hours. So I'm just going to just pub chucked it straight out into the middle of the lake. That's it. That's how it's going to stay for the dark period. And then when the sun comes up for a slight, I'll go straight back into those areas again. But no, that's it. Better safe than sorry. You watch us start catching bream again now. The bugs are starting to become a bit of a pain. So, on with the veil. Drug runner look. Into my drug runner look. Shut it. Well, that's it. Do you know what? First time I'll be able to talk normal all day. You just can't speak loud here at all because people can hear you. It's so quiet. It is so quiet. It's unbelievable. So if you fart over there, y'all can hear it. Yeah. It's the first time I've been able to speak all day. Yeah, I'm alone now. I don't think there's anybody on the lake at all tonight except me. So I've been out and bought a few things recently. But like I say, I've saved up from one of them's this light, which is a reactor light, petzl reactor light. So as you can see, if I turn and face another light, it dims. So I've got that, but, it's just telling me it's off. In here, there's a little device, and it's an infrared torch, and it sits perfectly on top of my camera. There it is. Little infrared torch. So I might just give it a try, see if it's any good. Yeah, let's turn it on. I'll have to take that mic off the top and put this on, but yeah, let's give it a go. So this is the night sight with the camera with its own lighting, but when I turn my infrared lighting on, it should get better. And I think we do one lot of lights first. There we go. So that's one lot, and then I have two bars across the top. So, and that's up to two. So now I've got pretty good night vision capability with this camera. I guess the range is probably about 10 meters. We'll have a look later, but as you can see, it's working perfectly fine. Whether it's useful for fishing or not, probably not, because you're gonna need a light when you're catching fish, yada, yada, yada. But for other things, maybe if I do any more ghost hunts, yeah, I have done that as well. If I do anything like that, then it come in handy. I can be on telly. But yeah. So that is my night sight capability with this camera. It's pretty good, isn't it? I mean, that's the built-in version anyway. It's probably still a little bit ambient light. But if I go back to normal camera, you won't be able to see anything anyhow. This place is quite secure at night. Obviously, it's got the otter fence all the way around it, but the gates and everything's strictly locked. As soon as you go through them, you've got to lock them again. So I know my vehicle's pretty safe where it's parked. I know that no one's going to get on here and try and nick me gear, because this, I'm in the middle of nowhere. But you've got the security, and if anybody comes through that gate, you can just hear them anyhow, because it's so quiet. Anybody moving around at night, you can just hear everything. It's just, you know, normally when you get to pits and you're next to motorways and it's just noise, but this is the complete opposite. It's hard to even talk to the camera, because as I'm talking to you right now, those people over there would have heard me, every single word that I was saying. So now it's a little bit darker. This is the camera at any distance. See, it doesn't really work from a distance. So let's see what happens when I use, first of all, one light. So that's not too bad, is it? Let's try two. There you go. Yeah, as I figured, about, yeah, not a super range, but about 6 to 7 meters of clear video at night. So that's not too bad, actually. I'm quite pleased with that. Well, to be fair, it is the only thing I'm going to eat until tonight when I get home from my dinner. Or tea, whichever you want to call it. Well, that does look rather nice, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. Well, good morning. And welcome to Father's Day. It's quite ironic, isn't it? Father's Day. I'm sure when it's Mother's Day that we do everything we possibly can to make sure Mum gets exactly what she wants and does exactly what she wants on that day. And we pamper Mum and we look after Mum. And now, when it comes to Father's Day, I think we're made to stay home and receive the little I love fishing socks, hats, scarves, mugs even, all the little memorabilia and little gifts that you get for Father's Day, yet you can't actually do what it is you want to do. This place is empty. There's only me on this entire complex. Nobody else is fishing. And there's something like 35 pegs. And it's Father's Day. And I bet most of them would like to go fishing. But no, look, there's nobody here. Completely empty. There's not a car in the car park except mine. Oh well, I find that quite ironic, really. I've just seen that carp back in this corner again. Swirling right above my baits. It was about this time yesterday that I had the run. Fingers crossed. If I miss it this time, I'm definitely moving. Because it looks like you get one shot a day in that corner. Anyway, time to keep my eye on the rod. Yeah, you're just staring at the swim. I'm about 50 metres from that swim. I can see my camera, so I'm in direct line of sight. I should be able to hear me okay. I'm not talking overly loud. Yep, ducks are seeing me scattering. Here we are. And there we go. You should be able to see me now. Hello. So I'll pick the last of my gear up and get back because I'm wasting battery on my camera. Whew. Right, so that rod's in, so I can see why these two chaps were really, really quiet yesterday. My next rod, I should really put it in the other margin, but I can't help myself, and I want to go out to that island which is there. I just want to get just slightly short of it. That's where I seen the fish yesterday. I'm not saying that they're there now, but I can't help it. I know there were fish jumping off that front of that island. So I'm gonna clip up, get closer, closer, closer. And when I get the right range, clip it up, put a pop up on it, job done. That's what I'm gonna do. Perfect. Well, my time is starting to run out. I feel like I'm flogging a dead horse this weekend. I think that one shot at the carp yesterday when it snagged me up was going to be my only one. I've not seen any signs. I've not seen any signs of any carp anywhere this morning at all. And I've fished 3 pegs, 9, 11, and 18 over the last 30 hours. And I moved from the only place I got a fish from. I have been suffering from COVID, and both Karen and I have been quite poorly. So if I've been a little bit different, That's why I'm still in the recovery mode, really. But I think I'm very, very close to calling it a day. Perhaps another hour at most, and then that's it. Yeah. I just need a sign, some confidence to let me know that, you know, there's still a fish in the area. I just need something to tell me that it's going to happen, but nothing at all. Dead. I'm not the only one on the lake now. There's a couple of lads around there and two lads turned up over here. So it turned up in the end. Just a few minutes ago, I said I needed a sign. I needed to see some carp. And they're all there. It's a huge shoal between me and the island. They're right in the middle of the lake. And they're all up on the surface. So I know I don't have a lot of time left. I'm definitely going to put a zig on. I've got to. I really, really, really want to zig a zig, yeah. I want to really, really, really want to zig a zig. Well, I've got a 2.5 foot zig on. Let's get it out where I've just seen them and see how we get on. Now that PVA foam didn't come back up. But it was on, it was only a small piece. So whether it dissolves underwater, there it is, it's just popped up now. So I know that that zig is right. Now I've got a 2.5 foot, and I'm gonna put a 5 foot zig on as well. Just gonna see how deep that is. And if I need to adjust it, the PVA foam will tell me whether it's sat on the surface straight away or not. So if I need to adjust it from there, I will do. I'm just gonna fire this out, slap bang, in the middle of the lake again. I do keep seeing them cruising past. In fact, here comes another one now, but I've noticed that they're in pairs. Are they getting ready to spawn? Not necessarily pairs, small shoals. Well, I know I'm not too shallow because I can't see the PVA foam and it's not popped up yet. There you go. The foam's just popped up now. My last hour's just extended to another last hour. I've got to give it a go. When you see them cruising past on the surface, you know they're not feeding from the bottom. So you've got to give it a go. And you can't fish biscuits or anything because the ducks just wipe you out in seconds. I don't think there's anything in the rules about not using zigs. I can't remember anything in the rules about not using zigs. I guess after I upload this video, I'll soon find out, won't I? I've come up the top here just to see if I can get a better angle of the fish cruising by. Now, the last time I seen anything like that, I was fishing in Oxford off a small island, and as the fish would come round, the water was crystal clear, and no matter what you put in front of those fish, they would not take it. They were not interested. So the bailiff said they were up for spawning, and I'm seeing the same behaviour again, whereas they go around the small shoals in pairs, one following the other, and they're just not into it. They'll just swim by any food that you put out for them. I'm just waiting for a couple to go by now, and then I'll zoom in on them. Hopefully we might be able to see them going through. Oh, see? Can you see the shoals? There's three there. See, that to me, that's pre-spawning. Do you know what I mean? They don't appear to be looking for food. They're just cruising, man. Cruising. It's a good shot, actually, because you've got the two blackbacks and you've got the one with the, like a koi. I don't know if it is a koi or not. I can't see too well with this camera. But they've split up now. We've got the two. And the one's gone off on its own. I just need him to do another 360 and come back and have a look at my bait. See if they want to try a zig. Fins out of the water. Soon I'm going to go out a shot. So what do you think? Did that look like pre-spawning behaviour to you, or do you think that was just three carp cruising? I think it's spawning behaviour. If you disagree, put a comment down below. Tell me what you think, but tell me why. I've just got my last barrel to push the last 50 metres, and that concludes my weekend, or my second weekend at Ratherheath. Unfortunately, I didn't get any carp, yeah, but beautiful surroundings, and I've really chilled out and needed it because we've both been poorly. I've been having to go to work and I just didn't feel like it. I just couldn't really cope too well, but I had to. So I needed a weekend just to relax and chill out. So yeah, it's a shame we didn't catch any carp, but I really have enjoyed the chill out. Even though I moved three times. So, it's a different kind of relaxing, isn't it? It's not a chill, sort of like a busy chill, but it's a nice busy chill. I don't know, does that make any sense? But there you go. That's it, end of the weekend. Thank you for joining me. I don't know what's gonna be next, but I do know in a month's time we've got the Fishing Blogger Social. So, if I don't see you until then, thank you. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.